Okay, so you can now see we're approaching up ahead this flat-topped whitish hill in the foreground. The background is again the Sierra Nevada mountains, and you can see that mountain front here rising like almost 10,000 feet vertically. And this flat-top hill is a rhyolite flow. And so rhyolite is a very thick type of lava. It's so thick that it won't flow any thinner than this hill. So this hill is, I don't know, maybe 100, 200 feet tall. And, you know, this stuff basically flows more like taffy than what you might traditionally think of as a liquid. So when it does flow, it produces these flat-topped hills. And the rate of flow would be extremely slow. Maybe, you know, meters per day or something like that. Here's a slightly closer view. So you can see they're actually mining it for, or they were mining it for perlite, which is hydrated. Oh, are they reoccupying this? Apparently there's new activity at this mine. That might make this more complicated. I don't really want to trespass on someone's private property. For a while it was abandoned, and I just went in there. Hold on. We're gonna reinvestigate. Okay, so I've just circled around a little bit. So yeah, you can see the people working there. There's a guy with a vehicle they're unloading. I guess they're actually unmothballing this plant here, and they're going to start mining perlite again. I am not a big fan of trespassing on private property. So we're just going to see if we can loop around. I don't know if it's a work or not. We're going to try and loop around to the back side. Okay, so here we are up at the west side of Perlite Dome. You can see down there is where they're mining it right now. Like I said, that mine's actually been mothballed for the last, I don't know, a couple decades now at this point. But I guess they're opening it back up. So this flow ahead of us, we'll just try and avoid the mining people today. Part of this flow, at least, is on BLM land, I think. I haven't really researched this carefully because we always used to go down there, so hopefully I'm not trespassing on anyone's land, but you never know. So we'll just cut over here, but you can see from here that it's a nice flat-topped hill. And that flat top, again, is good. So it came out of a vent somewhere up this way. And then it flowed down, you know, think of this like a big thick pancake, but it's like a 200 foot thick pancake or something like that. And so this would have been this lava flow erupted about a million years ago, and it's rhyolite, meaning that it's a very silica rich magma. And silicon likes to tie up to other silicon atoms and make big long chains, and those chains make it very viscous and thick. That make it only flow in such thick flows. And that resistance to flow also tends to make it very difficult for the rhyolite to crystallize. So when it cools quickly, it'll actually quench to obsidian or volcanic glass. Now if you look up ahead, you'll see this does not look like obsidian. Obsidian is black and shiny. If we look in the creek actually, here you can see there's some pieces of stuff that sort of looks like obsidian. But it turns out that over a period of a million years, the glass will actually absorb water from the atmosphere and from rain, and will change into something that's slightly different called perlite, which is basically just wet or hydrated volcanic glass.
And as it turns out, because of that absorbed water, if you take the perlite and you stick it in a furnace, it'll pop up like popcorn. And then all of a sudden you have this nice absorbent material that people use for things like those little puffy rocks you find in potting soil. That's perlite. And it, basically it absorbs water, and then it can store it for plants later use. Or it can be used for, you know, absorbing oil or other things. It can be used for a bunch of stuff. It also be a cement additive. So up here, as we get close to this, it looks like this part of the flow is not actually really made of perlite. Probably the perlite I was finding just from the mining road there, which looks recently resurfaced. So this just looks like a rhyolite breccia, basically. So you can see, if you look up close, there are little chunks in here of different pieces of rhyolite with flow banding in it. So this is probably a place where, when the rhyolite came up, it basically was fracturing brittlely into chunks. Those chunks were falling down the hill, and then they were probably hot enough they were sticking back together again to form this breccia texture. Well, that's about all we need to see here. Just give you a panorama over here. If we look off to the south, you can see there are a number of other lava flows, like over there, and cinder cones. So all the black and red features out here are various basaltic lava flows and cinder cones. And then off to the right again, we can see the Sierra Nevada. Nice straight front marked by a normal fault where the Sierra Nevada mountains have been lifted up like 3 kilometers or something like that, and the valley has been dropped down. Got some circling vultures out there. Maybe those are crows, actually. I can hear them crowing.